any delay. First tarpon on artificial with the TFO. Tactical Inshore. Hey guys, Captain Fraser here. Welcome to Flying Fish TV. Today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about some of the combos, the rod and reel combos that I've been using to catch Miami tarpon. This is my choice lately. Now, I've been using these rods and reel combos for over a year now from Temple Fork Outfitters, and I gotta say, this is probably a first for me. I haven't done a rod and reel combo video before, or a review or anything like that, but I really felt compelled after using these for over a year now, and I've used other rods, and this one seems to be, to me, a great value for the money and great action too. Here's a little bit of why, and here's why. This is a fast action rod, meaning the tip is going to flex and start to flex very fast. It makes it really good for fishing around those docks with really light baits. But on the business end, in the back end of this rod, in the meat, so to speak, it tapers slower. Has more of a moderate action, it's a lot stiffer, it's got more wraps back here. It's a very light rod, but it does have a lot of backbone to it for pulling those fish away from the docks. Now, this one here, and I'll show you the specs, this rod here is actually a 7.5 foot medium heavy, and it does have lure weights from 3/8 to 1 ounce, okay? So, 3/8 to 1 ounce, medium heavy. And the braid on this one is a 15, it's actually 10 to 20. The braid here recommendation is 10 to 20. This one I actually do have, I think I do have 30 on here just to give me some abrasion resistance, although I'm not pushing the drag up all that way when I'm using the Spheros 6000. Although this is a 7.5 foot, it makes it a real accurate cast. I probably would go with a 7 foot to get a little bit more accuracy. There is some distance involved in what we're fishing around these docks, so it's probably casting 50 to 60 feet, maybe 70 at the top end, probably generally around 45 to 50 feet is all you're required to cast. Now, I'm a guide using these rods, and I gotta say that these Fuji guides on this rod are the CNC Fuji guide, which is the corrosion control. And being a guide, I don't rinse. I rinse my rods off, but I certainly don't use a chamois. These do get rinsed and put away wet, and I'm just thoroughly impressed with these guides. They're not rusting up, and it's been over a year. Only just a little bit of hint there where I could probably polish that off. Now the guides themselves, ceramic. The braid just pours through there super fast. You don't get many wind knots. I haven't got many at all. Talking about the back section of this rod, it does have a 12-inch butt section here that does fit in your rod holders on your bay boat or your skiff. Makes it really easy. It's not short. Sits right up in there on a full-size rod holder. You can actually see here the actual blank that comes right into the reel seat, and that gives you a lot of sensitivity with this rod. It also lightens up some weight as well. On this business end here, I'm using a no live bait needed jig with a paddle tail combo. This thing is just super, super duper on those tarpon. Has a super strong hook, very lightweight bait, and that's what you need. You need a combo that's gonna be able to flick those light baits softly under the lights, under the docks, near the docks, not to disturb the fish. And then you just want that real small, almost glass minnow-like presentation, and I found that that's super key. And I've been real successful with this, and this is something I'm probably going to do a series on. I'm going to bring my next rod out, which is a beach, more of a bridge to beach tarpon fishing rod. And I'll do a series on those as well, where we do actually my heavier set that we do for the beach fishing. And I'm going to do a couple of tarpon videos that will explain a little bit more about these rods and reel combo setup as well that I'm doing. Now, this next rod is a little bit beefier. We went from the medium heavy, now we're here to the extra heavy. And here's the specs on this. Extra heavy, and this one is rated for the 15 to 40 pound braid. Now, being a fast action rod, I gotta say that probably most of you guys are used to using a rod. When you say fast action, I would say that an extra heavy, I would say that this is still a pretty flexible rod compared to some of the others on the market. But still, the extra heavy has a lot of backbone in it that enable us to pull out those tarpon from bridges and so on. This here is a 7 foot, 7 foot rod, still the 12 inch butt section, very similar to the other, the CC controlled Fuji guys, the corrosion controlled Fuji guys with a ceramic insert. I gotta say too, this rod is super impressive when it comes to walking the dog, walking those dog baits, especially in the backcountry. Got some videos there with some tarpon and snook, and just popping and walking the dog, the tip and the flex and the backbone just make that such a breeze. I was just astonished with how well that rod performs as far as flicking light baits like this Savage Gear shrimp, another ideal bait for tarpon fishing. Now, last night I was fishing this off the bridge and around the bridges, and it made an ideal presentation that's very similar to the natural shrimp that are around here in the bay, match the hatch, so to speak. Plenty of action on this rod to impart any kind of subtle twitches that you want to do with that shrimp. Now, on the reel setup here, I've been using this Shimano Bio Master for years now. It does have a slightly higher, faster retrieve, higher gear ratio, which enables you to keep up with the current around the bridge, but still make a nice light presentation. Plenty of capacity on here. In fact, in this case, I know I've got 50 pound braid, a little bit overrated for the rod. However, again, around that structure, I need a little bit more abrasion resistance in case I do get around there and I wanna be able to pull that fish out. 30 pounds of drag on this reel, probably never gonna use that, but more than adequate if I did. And the rod's gonna hold it too. I do have some super videos of my extra heavy 8.5 foot TFO Temple Fork Outfitters Inshore rods of working, doing some serious work on tarpon off the beach. I'll show you that too. Now, the specs on this rod are 1/2 ounce to 2.5 ounce baits. These are perfect for your lighter baits as well, your 1/2 ounce baits, your jigs, all the way up to my larger hoagie paddle tails at 2.5 to 3 ounces, and this rod will handle those perfectly, especially around docks. This is for your larger snook and your larger tarpon. This is a great combo. This is what I've been using, and the guys, I really wanted you to see this, as well as it's a fantastic rod for the budget. I feel that these really do give my clients a little bit of extra edge that puts us on some serious tarpon throughout the year. I'm going to be bringing to you another series of videos and tarpon clinics, so to speak, and about how we're fishing for these tarpon here in Miami. The next one will be my larger off the beach, near shore, extra heavy 8.5 foot Temple Fork Outfitter tactical inshore rods. Be sure to check that out. Click the link anywhere you see here for the next video. We've been fishing some extraordinary locations and visiting some really unique places. Go ahead and click the link below and check those out. And stay tuned for the next video and the next combo.